And our word for today on this memorial of Saints Cornelius and Cyprian, our word for today, remembrance. Remembrance, our word for today, and here to talk about it, Father Mark Davis. Good morning, Father Mark.
Father
Good
Mark.
Morning, Dave. Good morning. Dave, your ability to use words is beyond me. You said when you say fabulous, you mean fabulous. I thought when you said fabulous, you meant crazy or awful. But you know, the fact that when you say fabulous, you mean fabulous. What a use of words.
Yeah, and I think your explanation of that is fabulous. It's fabulous, I say.
I thought it was just interesting.
Speaking of what's going on, so a year ago, our Knights of Columbus at St. Pat's of Heatherdowns asked, hey, why don't we have like a priest appreciation dinner for you and Father Dave? I said, they see us all the time. That just doesn't seem like much of an event. But why don't you invite past priests, you know, and sisters to be able to come, you know, Monsignor Kabaki, Monsignor Metzger, Father Stripe, Father Petey, you know, Father Steinbauer, you know, Sister Joy Barker. And they're all coming this Wednesday.
Nice.
And they're calling it a memory dinner. Right. You can still get tickets for $25 by calling our parish office.
Beautiful.
Because a lot of people remember that. And they'll tell stories. It'll just be a hoot and a time just to be able to celebrate church and to celebrate our parish.
Mm-hmm. And we're eating for $25. I mean, there's food.
Oh, no.
Too.
And with hors d'oeuvres and, you know, happy hour. And, yeah.
Nice.
It's all good. It'll just be fun. You know.
Call the parish office there at St. Patrick of Heatherdowns. And I love that idea. So many of our priests have been pastors, have been associated with St. Patrick's at one time or another, and our sisters. Love it. Good
and
idea.
Great. Well, and I think other parishes can too. I think it's just nice to be able to just revisit those relationships.
Plus, it's a great tie-in. Remembrance, of course, our word of the day.
Yeah. Well, to remember. Absolutely. Well, there was a guy who was taking a driving tour of the United States. And he just kind of took a dirt road out west, and he found a Navajo reservation. And there are signs all over saying, the world-famous memory man. Mm. And then ask any question from his life, and he'll remember. So he goes, and there's a line of people to see this guy, and he goes up to the edge of the canyon, and there's a tribal elder sitting cross-legged watching the sunset. He approaches the memory man and says, what did you have for breakfast April 27th, 1987? And he said, two eggs. And the guy was just impressed and walked away. And, you know, and as it had it, like 15 years later, you know, he has other people with him. And then he revisits and the guy's still alive. He's at the same place and he goes up to him. You know, and being very polite, you know, he raises in and he said, how? And the guy looks at him and says, fried, a little crispy, over easy, two pieces of bacon, orange juice.
That's funny. Oh, my goodness. That's crazy. That's fabulous.
Do this in remembrance of me. And I think it's interesting to picture Jesus at the Last Supper, you know, with bread and holding it up and breaking it and seeing all of these little particles going everywhere. And Jesus says, you know, this is my body broken out for you. And then lifting up wine, and I'm picturing dark red wine, you know, that looks like blood, and saying, this is my blood poured out for you. When I'm gone, do this in remembrance of me. And I guess for years, I just thought, you know, like, do what in remembrance of him? And just have Mass and tell the story, right? But then I think at some point I read or said that maybe what Jesus was also saying is to break open our lives, you know, right? And to pour out our life's blood for each other, you know. And I think there is this sense of remembrance that every day and all the time we are to remember not only what Jesus did for us, but we're to do for others. And so that's one level of this. But this whole thing of remembrance reminds me of the Christophanic talk reboot that I saw last Wednesday. If anyone gets a chance to see him, it was terrific. And his main topic was about his book, Living Joy. His basic thing was, he says, look, if we are to proclaim Jesus Christ with our lives, and then we're always looking serious and always yelling at everybody, and even when we come to church, it's all sober, you know, no one's going to think there's God there at all. If we live joy, though, in a world that doesn't have it, then we can proclaim with our lives that God is here because we have joy. There's nothing that will say to people that God is in us and God is real than having joy. And he said there's three things to do to be able to have joy in your life. And the first one is gratitude. So when I'm thinking of remembrance today, I'm thinking that God calls us to remember that we have cause for joy. I am not a morning person. For all of you who are morning people, you know, when you stay up later, you feel awful, you know, and you're tired. And that's how I feel every morning when I get up. But it's just the body. But what Christophanic says is, if we're grateful that we can remember and have remembrance of all the things that God has done for us, everything in our life, we have all the ways that God is present, then we can start the day and live the day every day with gratitude. And just remind ourselves, no matter what our body says that moment, that God is here and God is good and God loves us. And we will have eternity love with him forever. For we are to call out to remember how much God is good and to be able to live it with joy in our lives.
Ooh, beautiful.
Thank you, Father Mark.
Fabulous.